Hallo. Day 3. And Sunday. In the United States. Stress with a wife. And I'm in Tulloch right now. Played 2 poker tournaments, one no limit, early at 9 o'clock. Didn't went so well, but I was an alternative 22, so the blinds were already quite high when I started. So the second one, limit hold'em high-low, or 08. That was super fun. The people that are playing this tournament, just super fun. Okay, I had 2 hours of fun for $40. That's all right. And now we're looking at an apartment, maybe. I don't know. Still here in Tulloch. I'm getting ready to depart. Just got gas. That was really necessary. And... oops! It's getting warm. This morning, and in this book room, I was just freezing. 17 degrees outside, Celsius, of course. Now it's getting 24. But by the minute, it's just increasing, and then later it's 30 degrees again. And I'm wearing my boots and long jeans, so I think I have to change because I'm sweating like a dog. And as we all know, no, I'm actually sweating like a horse because dogs are not sweating. We all know that. Yeah, still on the way back from Tulloch to Modesto on this beautiful highway. And I just want to mention something. So since, well, I don't know since, but since I'm back, obviously, you are smelling weed out of every second or third car. That's just incredible. So smoking weed is legal here in California for recreational use even. Of course, you shouldn't drive under the influence of drugs, obviously, but damn, it looks like everyone is smoking weed here. What the heck is going on? All druggies now here. Oh god. Back at the hotel. I just got a message from my wife. She found the headset in the storage unit. She went there again. And she just said she found it. 10 minutes after she arrived there. We looked for it really, really hard. And it was dusty and hot yesterday as well. And we looked there for 3 hours. So, wow. That's great. With my headset, wow, that's great. Okay, we're getting ready to leave our hotel room again. I'm talking to my wife again. And the plan is to go to the World Market pretty quick, where we can find German food stuff. And then have a look at an apartment where we might move into. So, let's go. Yeah, like I thought and predicted, it's 30 degrees. Beautiful fall day. And there are our cars. Both of us have our cars back. So we are independent. And yeah, you need a car here to go somewhere or to get somewhere. So shit, it happened again. If you push this stupid button, it does this, but I hit this stupid button here all the time. Oh. Just sitting in the car, extremely warm, and it's even 31 degrees. So it's freaking hot, especially when you're not used to it at the end of October. But as a German, Northern European or whatever, my wife says we are more or less, or should, in Germany we have the weather like the Canadians have, but I don't think, and I don't agree, but she might be right. She's kind of smart. Okay, we just arrived at the World Market. World Market means they have tons of international staff, also from Germany. And now
Have a look. It's of course crazy expensive. But let's have a look.
Okay, it is. Hello.
Hello. Oktoberfest, honey.
That's right. Franciscana and stuff. Christmas stuff. I thought there's Halloween before that. Okay, just let's go one. No, it's not gonna work. So obviously I know already what the German stuff is. But oh, here is Halloween.
Hi.
Does it do something? It's just a nun. Oh, look at this. Oh yeah, it's doing something. I thought the nun is doing something as well, but... Here we're getting started with a good sweets. No, that's not the German section area, actually. Oh, they changed quite a bit the arrangement, but here we go. Look at this. But you can see the prices here, $3 for a milk car. That's quite a lot. $6 for 5 pound, yes. That's all right. Haribo, also $3. Oh, $2 here for those, but they're not very good. But yeah, if you want something German, you have to get creative. So yeah, let me show you some prizes here, because sometimes they are really ridiculous. Here, $1.99 for Maggi. I think in Germany you can get them for 50 cents. And less when they're discounted. So... So yeah, they rearranged everything. So I wanted to go there right away and show you stuff, but I have to figure out it first. Because this right now is more or less... you can't find anything anymore. So yeah, here's a good example for prizes. Which surprised me. Deutschländer, $9.99. Die guten deutschen Cornichons. The good German Cornichons, $5. Sauerkraut, $3.69. Yeah. But sometimes I buy it anyway. So yeah, they started to sell tons of Christmas stuff as well, already, in October, middle of October. These are the best. Sadly, they cost $5. But sometimes they're discounted, 50%, so I wait for this time. And I'm on a diet anyway, so it's probably a good thing. Look at this here, $9. Oh my god, that's so good. So yeah, we didn't buy anything this time in the world market, surprisingly. But we have an appointment in 20 minutes, or less than 20 minutes, for our apartment, so we have to hurry a little bit, so let's go. So, we arrived in the apartment complex, gated area, which is pretty nice. It's actually the area we lived before, for 2 years. And it's just, of course, not the same apartment, obviously, they sold it after they pushed us out. But we know the area, they have 2 tennis courts, never ever someone is playing tennis there. Maybe I'm get lucky and find an opponent, or at least a victim I can beat all the time, or get, you know, stay current in tennis. Okay, let's have a look at the apartment. So we just had a look at the apartment. I didn't want to get a GoPro out there because the lady was super nice, and I don't know. People react differently, and, you know, I don't know, she wants to get rid of the apartment, and then she probably doesn't want to say no, but maybe I didn't do it. So I give you a quick update about this. It was just an amazing
more or less new looking apartment. And I didn't know that there usually is no fridge in the apartment, but she's selling her brand new fridge for almost half price. And everything is new and looks great. It's an upstairs unit, two bedrooms, and it's just huge and it's just amazing. So if we could figure out, if you can pay for it, and if we are able to really get a 6-month lease, and then after that month by month, because you never know how everything will work out with my job and her job and whatever, with life, that would be great. And then we could take it starting on the 23rd of October already, which is in 9 days, which is also perfect because we need it soon. It would be cool. So we're in the Halloween store now, and as usual for me, it's crazy what's going on here. From last year.
Yeah.
Not the mask, I quite interesting looking. Skull, see it. Step on it.
Nothing happened.
It's supposed to happen something, eh?
Nothing's
happening. We put it up, switch it up. Right? Why is it not working? This shit is working, right? No, it's not working. You're supposed to
stay. It's still not working. None of it's working. What a disappointment.
Totally disappointing. Oh, something is happening here. Oh, no, the acting with delay, huh? But this is a cool one. Even moving the eyes. That's a creepy mask,
that's
right?
That's a
I didn't see any October stuff. No. So when I want to go as a prostitute, what do I do? Ah, they have this weird shit stuff as well.
The steampunk stuff. It has a
whole category for steampunk,
yeah.
Yeah. It's weird.
That's very weird.
What's this? Toby? Who's Toby? Some kind of horror?
I don't know Toby.
But this is an awesome mask.
Yeah, that one's cool.
I love it. Awesome. Halloween is kind of cool here because it's huge. Sexy stuff. Yeah, but that's it, huh? For
not really something. Yes, that sounds. Yeah. What's that? Ah, leg warmers. Okay. That's it. Let's go. Spiders are jumping.
So we just went through the Halloween store. You just saw it. It was cool, but not as spectacular as I thought. Anyway, those guys who are usually jumping around, they're supposed to. But they should have worked better. You know, we waited forever for something on it that didn't work right. But it was cool. Let's see. Didn't buy anything.
Yeah. So we just had dinner at Panda Express and it was one of the most disgusting experiences food wise ever. No, it was not so bad actually. I'm full. And that was the main purpose. So, let's get some walnuts.
So, here's another thing. Driving as a German in America. So it's not for all states, but in California. So you can go on a red traffic light to the right. When it's free, you can go. But that's not the weirdest thing, because we have the green arrow and then you can do it as well in Germany when you stop. The weird thing here is the stop signs. So they have a stop sign and then usually additional information. And either it has a stop sign which says always, or it says
two ways.
Two ways means out of two directions there's a stop sign and the other guys had a right of way. So we have this in Germany as well. What we don't have is a four-way stop sign. So on an intersection, out of all four directions, everyone has to stop, and who came first goes first. That's super weird. So of course it slows down the entire traffic, but it makes the intersection definitely safer. But it's super weird. At the beginning when I came here, I didn't know what's going on, and I just stopped and waited forever until the guy behind me got a little bit bad.
Here's the always stop.
Oh yeah, here's the always stops, exactly. It says always.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, I don't know if you were able to see it, but if you don't go immediately, boom, after you were first, those guys who are used to it, Americans usually, they get a little bit angry. But now I'm used to it, and I think it's cool. Okay, my wife, Leanne, she just told me there might be an intersection where four cars arrive at an intersection with a four-way stop sign situation, and they're arriving at the exactly same time. So who has the right of way? They have a solution for this. The guy who goes to the north goes first. So
comes from the north.
Comes from the north.
Yeah, from the north.
He's going south.
Yeah, correct. He's going south. That starts first. Yeah.
Okay. Then.
Yeah.
So this is why I have on the mirror here not only temperature indicator, I can also switch to the compass indicator, and then I know when I go north, south, or whatever. So it never happened to me actually, but it can happen, and then you know.
It's pretty rare.
Yeah, it's rare, obviously, but this one to the thought. So I made a driving license test here. But no one ever helped me. Yeah, this is a curve here. So they took down a bunch of old almond trees
or orchards.
thousands, at least hundreds, but it looks like thousands of small little elm trees. That's amazing. So they just put it in there. This is really, I don't know, not even 1 or 2 months old.
Yeah. This is very
we just passed 1 year old trees and 2 year old trees, and they're growing in this environment just like crazy. So for 2 years you're not able to harvest, but then yeah, you're making profit again.
So we just arrived at our destination, the walnut trees. And as I showed you, these are the walnut trees, and there are hundreds and hundreds of walnuts down there. You're not supposed to collect them. You can buy them. Let's go.
There's a truck coming, so we can't get started right away. But actually, I don't think that anyone cares besides the owner, but you never know which one is the owner. But it will not take forever to get a bunch of walnuts. We don't want to pick tons of walnuts. We just want to fill up a small little bag, and then we're getting out of here immediately. So let's go. It's so exciting to do something what you not supposed to do, but it took us about 2 minutes.
Yeah.
2 minutes.
Not even 2 minutes, I don't think.
To get some nice almonds here.
Yeah. Walnuts.
Walnuts.
Not almonds.
So that's good for now. We don't have more bags. We could have just taken as much as, oh my god, but let's get out of here. America. So after this successful day, we found the headset, I talked to my wife again, and we have got some walnuts, and we visited the Baby Our Future apartment. It's time to relax. So let's go to the whirlpool. No one is here anymore, the hotel is almost empty, it's Sunday evening, and the weekend of course was a little bit more busy here, but there's no one at the spa. There's no one everywhere. The parking lot is empty. So the entire place is ours. So let's do it. All right, like I said, no one is here anymore. Everything is silent besides the street, obviously. But my wife is already in the whirlpool. And I will follow now, because they call it spa.